phone when they had phones back then. But he started a song with service and different other people and crying and talking to them because they can't fix nothing. Not to that degree. Yeah, then you do need people you can console with and talk to. The Bible talks about it and acknowledges that the multitude of counselors, there is a limited peace and surrender. But at the same time, you gotta have a relationship with God yourself.
Amen.
To the point where you can pray for yourself and pour water on yourself. You ain't gotta call your prayer partner, grieve your own self. You ain't gotta pray no, don't use all cooking oil, just get a little dab. It's gonna be just symbolic, all it is, you just wanna anoint yourself and you gotta believe God. You can use all the praying oil you want. And it ain't gonna be, it can be the frankincense, it can be the myrrh, but if God ain't in your heart and sincere, you just grease it. That's all it is. Last point I want to make, and I'm bringing this to a close now. Where I said you always say you're gonna close, but I'm closing this time, honey. And you can bang on. The life of a Christian is a life lived by faith,
yeah.
And living by faith is in everything expecting God.
Yeah.
When we make these three values, pleasure, possession, position, our pursuit then becomes lust. When God bestows them freely upon us. Within the guidelines of Scripture, in His timing, they become blessings. That's why we have to want things in God's timing and not our own, because we're facing so much in this nation. I don't even want to just list them because it's so many things we're facing. As number one, as believers, and number two, as people of color. So there's a lot of things we're facing. But in order for us to channel and work our way through this maze of life and so many pressures that are coming around us, and we could be like David, we could continue to look up to the hills.
Yeah.
From which coming our help, knowing our help comes from Him that will protect them. And we ain't talking no man upstairs. I acknowledge, I ain't scared to say Jesus. In the White House, I ain't scared to say Jesus. And down there at City Hall, I ain't scared to say Jesus. At Roslyn Street, front of the man, it don't make me no difference. I ain't gonna be talking about the man, the God of the boon and stuff. No! He's Jehovah Jireh. He's Jehovah Nissi. He's Jehovah Shalom. But we have to have a firm stand.
Amen.
In Him who we say we serve.
Amen.
And just like David.
Amen.
And all these written examples in God's word. It can become your life.
Amen.
It can become your way of life.
Amen.
Yes, it's gonna get hard. It's gonna be some tough decisions. But the tough decisions, we got an ultimate goal.
Yeah.
Do you really believe there's a heaven to hell?
Yeah.
I question some people. How they live. Do you really believe? Because it looks like you're just trying to, you make sure you're trying to amass everything. And I see people sometimes on Facebook, it seems like they got everything you can think of. They making money, they doing well, they doing this. But they be the first one on Facebook to talk mean and bitter.
Yeah, amen.
Mm-hmm. Single people, I don't need this, I don't need that, and I just get my money. But money only serve a point.
That's right.
It only go to a point. I thank God for a wife. Because
yes.
A wife can do what money can't do. Yeah, money pay bills and take you on vacations. You get to see some things, that's great. But if you ain't got nobody to share life with.
Ha, come on now.
It's almost like meaningless to a degree. That's what the Bible says. He don't want us to be alone. He created companionship for a purpose.
Yeah.
And I know sometimes we go through divorces and we go through things, and those things happen. A flat tire, it happens. I don't care how brand new your tires are. You hit a pothole, the tire just blow.
Yeah.
Get another tire. Don't sell yourself off or sell yourself short because something happened in your life.
Mm.
And sometimes we gotta get delivered from our own perspectives.
Yeah.
Our own decision. We can't keep making repetitive decisions and think we're going to get different answers.
Yeah,
we got to be determined, saints. We got to be so determined about this thing to the point, about our relationship, not a thing, correct myself, about our relationship with God to the point that we are willing to go all the way.
Amen.
And sometimes we have to correct ourselves and say, you know what? I ain't been managing this right. I got to manage better. I got to do better.
Yeah.
Well, if the cable too much, we're just going to cut it off because I'm tired of being broke. Come on, somebody. I'm tired of experiencing what I'm experiencing. If I had to go down to nothing to be able to be built back up, then that's what I have to do because I've experienced that before in the natural.
Amen.
I only had to return home one time and get myself back together. And I'm not ashamed of it. Why? Because I knew that was the best thing in my interest to do. I went back home as an adult.
Yeah.
I ain't go back there no more. Because my mom and dad already raised me. So they were is complete, but it's up for me to take what's been distilled in me for my life to be what it ought to be. And it's the same thing in God's word. We've been inundated with it. Now what you gonna do with it? What you gonna do with the information you got? And that's how we grow saints. We have to continuously see God in all things. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I just thank you for this day. Thank you just for life helping.